problems, complexities and delays. We'd rather not have them, especially on busy live construction sites. But what if a project could be seen and experienced and problems solved during pre-construction? Well, the Carey Group has an in-house design team of BIM technicians and 4D specialists whose job it is to digitally create a safer, smarter, better project.
Okay, so we just put this on now. Okay. Okay, so what we're looking at the moment is on principal place. If you turn to your right, you can see the jacks.
I'm going on a virtual tour of the 50-storey principal tower in Shoreditch in East London. This is the floor currently being built, and this virtual reality simulation is the work of Carey's design team. It's a vital tool in getting from drawing board to construction site.
You can almost be teleported. Imagine you have a crystal ball where you can actually travel in time and you can see your problems before they happen, and it gives you the chance to fix those problems. As they say, a picture tells a thousand words, and for the lads on site, it's critical to visualize the project before it happens.
The rig being used to build the tower is a first in Europe. Carey's identified this self-climbing jump form system in Dubai, and one floor can be built every week. They adapted it to increase safety and efficiency and comply with UK standards, adding ladders, access points, a rescue cage, first aid and fire kits and so on. It was a joint effort with their health and safety team.
It makes it a lot easier when you've got visualisation, because you can put yourself in the scenario and you can imagine walking around the work area, because we're putting operatives into the scenarios as well, and we can look to either extend or prepare the rig so that we've got walkways, safe storage areas for materials, so that we can flow and sort of move around the rig as safely as possible.
Around the core, around the bottom deck, top deck.
On site, the supervisor gives his daily toolbox talk or briefing using pictorial method statements on notice boards created by the design team.
If somebody new is coming on the job first day, you can look at the board and there you go. You go in top deck, you have everything here. Bottom deck, you have everything there. Accesses and emergency.
He can also use a tablet to show details of each task.
The noise that you can hear is the concrete which is being pumped up this pipe from 38 floors below at street level, and that's being used to make all of the floors and the vertical walls here. Another thing to say is, as soon as we arrived here, everything seemed familiar, the layout, because of the virtual reality goggles and the fly-through that I did earlier today.
Careys call it the concrete factory in the sky, and it was a culture shift to move the whole team over to this new way of working.
For us, part of what we do is always about delivering certainty. We can't afford problems 40 stories up. We need to engineer how we solve problems before we put the guys to work. I've failed in my job if we give the guys tools that they can't use. So the key of getting the buy-in from all of the guys and simulating every step of how we were going to operate the rig, build the rig, dismantle the rig, was key before we put it out on site.
Imagine delivering a large project like that while the public are coming and going. It's a Grade 1 listed building and it's made of glass. At the Royal Opera House in Covent Garden, Scudder Demolition, a Carey Group company, tackled it again using CGIs. They digitally modelled excavation works at the front of this Victorian section, removing the old columns and opening up the entrance area. A key step was installing a large load-bearing transfer truss to support the cast iron structure above. They also had to work around a weekly schedule of performances and rehearsals.
The movement of that building was critical, i.e. we couldn't allow it to drop or deflect as we were installing the transfer arrangement. So we had to install a system of jacks and temporary works to make sure that we completely controlled all movement of the Paul Hamlin Hall.
And how did that go?
Exceedingly well. We didn't break a single pane of glass.
Two examples of what they call the Carey way of working. The family company invests and owns all its own equipment, employs its staff directly, and aims to create a culture of what it calls being better every day, with safer and smarter ways of operating.